to thank you this morning. Want to lift you high. Want to say that you are God and there is no one like you. Want to celebrate your awesome power. And whom you are in us, we are confident in you because you are the one that do all things. Lord, accept us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, accept our thanks in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, I declare and I make bold concerning that person that your head will be roaring. Every evil and writing attached to your life. I come up from this altar in the name of Jesus. Let God plug it out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Olorun lo fe gbe nikan ku olowo atunida. He wants to deliver you from the hands of people that recreate you. I command in the name of Jesus. If there is any power or any force that recreates you, your identity, your destiny, and your life, I pray in the name of Jesus, let God deliver you from the hands. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Colossians chapter 2 verse 14 says, blotting out the handwriting of ordinance that was against us, which was contrary to us. Every contrary message, every contrary life you have been living, every contrary system that appear on your matter, I want your amen to be louder. I come up by the power of the Holy Ghost. Oh yeah, let it be blotted out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now I pray today, contrary system attacks to your system of life. You have been working harder but nothing to show for it. You have served as you are asked to serve but nothing to show for it. Other people are entering into your harvest. I pray in the name of Jesus, every evil and writing that see you up, I command in the name of Jesus, oh yeah, remove by fire.
Amen.
I want you to roar. Say, every evil and writing.
Every evil and writing.
Can you shout it very loud?
Every evil and writing.
Disturbing my moving forward.
Disturbing my moving forward.
Say, what are you waiting for?
What are you waiting
hear
for?
Hear the word of God.
Hear the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Put your blood up by fire.
Blood up by fire.
Fire, fire, fire. Fire, fire. You better shout this in the name of Jesus.
Blood up, baby. Blood up, baby.
Let your voice be louder. Blood up in the name of Jesus.
Blood up, baby. Blood up, baby.
Shout it, shout it, shout it. Shout it, shout it, shout it. Aha. In Jesus' name we pray. Every lock gate fighting your lifting. Every lock gate fighting your business. Every lock gate fighting your marriage. Every lock gate fighting your moving forward. Every gate of oppression and oppressors. Fighting your life. Arising from this meeting. I pray in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah, let that gate break up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Psalm 24, I'm reading from verse 7 to 10 says, lift up your head, O ye gates. And be ye lifted up, lift up ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. I pray for you today as I pray for myself. By the power of God, let the King of glory come into our gates in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Before any doors could be opened, gates must be opened first. And if the man and the girl refuse you to gain entrance, you go nowhere. But the Lord is standing at the gate. Get of your marketplace. Get of your marital entrance. Get of your ministerial cartel. I pray in the name of Jesus. The gate of your generational problem. I command in the name of Jesus. The Lord Almighty will open the gate in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So everywhere you see, there is a gate. To every nation, there is a gate. When they lock the gate of Nigeria to other border, the people are crying. Other countries are crying. Nigeria people are crying. Why? Because the gate is locked. Hear this. There is no physical gate, but they lock the border. The difference between the border and this is just the barrier. The barrier is just there. It's not locked yet to any border. But hear the word of God. There are men at the entrance of the gate that made the gate not to be open. I command in the name of Jesus. Oh yeah, let the gate be open in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want somebody to be serious today. Anywhere you are, the gate of that country, you are there abroad, nothing is working. It's because the gate of that nation is shut against you. But hear this. There are men at the entrance of every gate. We want to summon them now. Oh my God. And we call them out. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
We want to do what?
Call them out.
We want to summon them. And we call them out. Can I hear you shout out? Amen.
Amen.
Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 1 and 2. Ezekiel 9, 1 and 2. He cried also in my ears with a loud voice, saying, cause them to have charge over the city. So run here. You call them near. Hey! Even every man with his destroying weapon in his hand. And behold, six men came from the way of the high gate. Studio, are you ready for us? Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 2 now. And behold, six men came from the way of the high gate. Take note of this. There is a gate there. But physically, there is no gate. Which lie towards the north. And every man a slaughter weapon in his hands. Hey! And one man among them was clothed with linen. With a writer hickron by his side. And they went in and stood before the brazen altar. I pray today, every man with a destroying weapon at the gate of your business environment, gate of your location where you live, I prophesy in the name of Jesus by the order of God, let every man at the gate that is holding you, let the slaughtering agent of God visit them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, gate of my territory.
Gate of my territory.
If you are facing issues in your marriage, say, gate of my marriage.
Gate of my marriage.
Can you shout it very loud? Say, gate of my generation.
Gate of my generation.
Hear the word of God. Shout it. Say, hear the word of God. In the name of Jesus. By the power of the Holy Ghost. As I'm clapping my hands. Oh yeah, open by fire.
By fire.
You better shout it. Let us get open in the name of Jesus.
Aha.
Aha. Aha. Aha. I like the way you're praying, that woman. Aha. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
When you are sleeping, there are men at the entrance of the gate over the night to pollute the gate against you and to program something in their favor. There is gate in your business place. There is a gate in your academic circle. There is a gate in your ministerial circle. There is a gate among your peers. There is a gate in your office, you that you're supposed to have been promoted, but they are shifting your promotion. There is a particular gate. And there are men at the entrance of the gate. But I pray today, by the order of God, let the power of God visit your gate in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 11, verses 5 and 6. Revelation 11, 5 and 6 says, and if a man will hurt them, fire proceeded out of their mouth and devoured their enemy. And if any man will hurt them, he must in this manner be killed. Hey, verse 6. Can we read it together? Very last one, okay, I want to go. This has power to shut heaven. Take note of that. Those men are the gate. That are coming with your slaughter weapon. Can we read the verses together? Want to go louder? This have power to shut heaven. that he reign not in the day of their prophecy. Today is the day of prophecy.
Amen.
Can I ask you to prophesy?
Yes, sir.
Concerning everything that troubles your life, I command in the name of Jesus, I raise you, I raise this altar. You as a prophet that will prophesy. Let the day of your prophecy profit provide for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now say, I prophesy.
I prophesy.
Can you shout it very loud and clear?
I prophesy.
Concerning this unpleasant situation.
Concerning this unpleasant situation.
Troubling my life.
Troubling my life.
Say, hear the word.
Hear the word.
By prophecy.
By prophecy.
Disappear.
Disappear.
Say, amen.
Amen.
Say, I prophesy.
I prophesy.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
By the right of God.
By the right of God.
You that unpleasant life.
You that unpleasant
that
life.
Believe,
that I believe.
What are you waiting for?
What are you waiting
disappear.
For?
Disappear.
Disappear.
When it is time for the season of prophecy, they have power to shut heaven. They are the men at the gate. To heaven gate, there are people there. And to the heavenly gate, there are people there. In the days of their prophecy, what happened? Nothing will happen. And if anybody wants to stop them, they said the people is killed. They have power. To tell rain not to stop because they want to prophesy. Meaning that they can control every manner of things. I pray today. Those agents of divine assignment, on the sign of divine assignment, as you are leaving this place today, they will follow you.
Amen.
Oh my God, you are not shouting. I said they will follow you.
Amen.
I said they will follow you.
Amen.
We are going to three sections. This first section, I want you to grab it very well. It's for declaration. The second section is also like that for help. And the third section, if you can get here, is to put up the negative identity. So I pray to the name of Jesus because they have power to shut heaven in the day of their prophecy. There is a prophecy that has gone forth ahead of you, negative prophecy. Say, your marriage will not enjoy sweetness. Say, your business will not work. Say, you will remain as a servant, but you will not be served. There are prophecies that have gone for, say, you'll be moving around any city you find yourself and nothing to show for it. There are prophecies that say, lay your hands on it, nothing will work. I pray, is that in their days of prophecy, they have power to shut heaven. Hey, they have power to shut heaven. That he ran not in their days of what? Prophecy. And have power over water. They have power over what?
Waters.
They have power over what?
Waters.
I'm in verse 6, please. They have power over waters to turn them to blood. And to smite the head with all plagues as often as they will. That means power is being given to their hands. I pray today.
I receive it.
Somebody is here. You are living this life with the power that will not go away from your hand. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
There are forces of God at the entrance of every gate. There are demonic forces at the entrance of every gate. There was a time in the realm of spirit concerning a prophet that said, who are the people in charge of this area in the realm of the spirit? And they appeared. Anyone in charge of environment tormenting your going in life, every strange wind and strange breeze concerning your life, Apaliaza, that person in Lebanon, like the Caponi Bosotuplaiaza, Hada. That gate of that city shall be open and the people will disappear. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you leave this place today, you are turning to a territorial commander.
Amen.
Say, that is my real identity.
That is my real identity.
I said, you are turning to a territorial commander.
Amen.
Can you hear me? Be shouting
amen. Amen.
Acts chapter 17, verse 1 and to 6. Acts 17, 1 to 6 says, now, when they are passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia, They came to Thessalonica, where was synagogue of the Jews. And Paul, as his manner was, went in unto them, and 3 days, 3 Sabbath days, reasoning with them out of the scripture. To open Bible. Opening all a line that Christ must need to have suffered. Arise again from the dead. And that this Jesus who I preach unto you is Christ. Verse 4. And some of them believed and consulted with Paul and Silas, and of the devout Greeks, a great multitude of the chief women, not a few, but the Jews which believed not, moved with envy, took unto them certain lewd fellows of the baser sort, and gathered a company, and set all the city on uproar, and assaulted the house of Jason, and sought to bring them out to the people. Verse 6, can we read it together? Very loud, so I can want to go. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the ruler of the city, crying, this that have turned the world upside down and come hither also. Anywhere you go from today, any gate that refuses to open, you will turn it upside down.
Amen.
Are you shouting amen or you are begging to shout?
Amen.
Gate of the noble shall be opened unto us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
To that person in that country, gate of that nation shall be opened unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hear this word. Then lift up your head, O ye gates. And be ye lifted up. Psalm 24, verse 7. Ye everlasting doors. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. As mighty as God is, so are his angels and his agents. The Lord mighty in battle. That means your God is a fighter. That if you don't fight, whom will you say you resemble? But here it is. Your fighting strategy is already been accomplished because Jesus fought it for you. All you need to do is to enter into the harvest and claim the promises. And verse 9 said, lift up your head, all you get. Even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts is the King of glory. I pray today, if you can shout this amen, that power at the gate of your life, using your secret place as a medium to fight you, they shall lose their hold over your life in the name of Jesus. Do you know Samson got married to a woman who was searching for the secret place of Samson? Because of what? Assignment is being given to her. And they said, if you do this, we'll give you everything you need. She entered into the marriage not because of love, but because of lust. And Samson died on her lap. Say, if I didn't die on the bed sleeping, let me die on the lap of a woman. And the woman rubbed the hair first time, second time, third time. It was rubbing the hair. And the man said, it's because you did not love me. Enter into a secret place to affect him. Judges 16, verse 5 to 6 says. Judges 16, verse 5 to 6 says. And the Lord of the Philistines came unto her. That is Delilah. Is he, what is your name now? Delilah. Any Delilah spirit in the life of anyone here tormenting your mind and the mind of your wife and your wife to be, I command in the name of Jesus, that spirit will disappear.
Amen.
Delilah spirit in your business, I command in the name of Jesus, disappear.
Amen.
Delilah spirit in your ministry, I pray in the name of Jesus, disappear.
Amen.
The host of Philistines said to her, and said to her, entice him and see where his great strength lies, and by what means we may prevail against him, that we may bind him to afflict him, to prevail, to bind, and to do what? To afflict. To prevail, to bind, and to do what? To afflict him. And we give thee, every one of us, 11 orange pieces of silver. Hey! Over what I fear. Every one of us will give you money according to your request. If you even need more than that, we give you the money. Hear the word of God today. All Zion that is lying waste without wisdom, I pray in the name of Jesus, why have you turned to Babylon? I command in the name of Jesus, let there be deliverance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Verse 6. And Delilah said to Samson, tell me, I pray thee, where in thy great strength lie? Where is the secret of your strength? And where will thou, my health, be bound to afflict you? She carried out that assignment bomber to bomber. Where is her area? What is that thing that we can use to afflict you? Where can I bind you to afflict you? It was proving Superman. Never know that God has left him. He was saying, when he was arrested finally, I will go out like the former days. But he turned to a man that is grinding corn in the presence of his enemies. Hear this. When ice is useless, is to pluck it out. And what happened? When his strength disappeared, they removed his eyes. And when he was about to die, he prayed only one prayer point that I've heard him praying. Say, Lord, please, let me die with my enemy just to avenge one of my eyes. And God gave it to him. Maybe if he said, Lord, open my eyes to see. Maybe God will open his eyes. But his request was, I want to die with my enemy. The word of the Lord says, the head grew back. After the prayer. Do you know how many days or months he has been in that place that the air refused to grow? But with 1 second prayer, the glory was restored. And his answer and his prayer was answered. The prayer was, Lord, help me so I can die with my enemy. Need that? Lord, I need that power. And the air grew back. And the prayer was answered. And he died with his enemy. Are you here today? That your prayer has been done. Let me die with my enemy. I pray God will change that standard of prayer in your mouth. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Delilah asked him, where is the secret of your power? Beli so wi pe oruko Oluwa ile isu agbara ni. Say the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Strong tower is a secret place. People might be there, but you don't know them. Can I tell you, Babylon has almost 10 towers where they secure the place. When the invaders wanted to invade Babylon, no permission, he entered like an ant and turned to elephant in the city of Babylon. There was nobody to come in. They don't do business with anybody. The Lord bless them. They are like Saudi Arabia. But hear the word of God today. Anyone that sneak into your secret place will afflict you. I want your helmet to be louder. I command in the name of Jesus. Let God expose them and disgrace them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are you here? You freely submit your secret place into the custody of your enemy. Say, take care of my secret place. Take care of my secret place. A lot of women will be fighting their husband. When you say, my husband used to follow women. It's not to fight your husband. It's to get your husband closer to you, not to fight. When you fight, you are telling him way out. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Majority of women in church, their first prayer point is my husband, not my children. Their second prayer point is what? My husband. Their third prayer point is what? My business. They don't even pray for themselves. But by the time God answered the prayer, going back to the house, they saw their husband in exit. Your husband wants to be with you in the order of husband and wife. You are saying, go and meet that one. What are you telling him? Go back. You are only one. Your husband is meeting with 17 big Ikebe. 21 breasts, they see them every day. Are you hearing me? They don't even ask the money, they are spending for him. They open the lap. Do not, for women to open lap is spiritual. You know that? For women to open their lap is very spiritual. Your husband toast you, marry you, pay for your dowry, he will still toast you for you to open your lap. Is it not true? But there are some people, they open it without toasting. And every wise man should be careful for that. That is sepulchre. Burial ground in Allah. They are ready to bury you alive. They open it without apologetic things. And then we just open it. No apology. No, no, nothing for that. And you put your secret place into sepulchre. And you are happy. I don't nap that woman. I don't nap the baby. I don't nap that one. Hey, you don't nap your destiny. But every woman should be careful not to show their husband way out anymore. It's a secret thing I'm telling you today. This is one of the things God said I should say. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
people watching online, it might not be working out. Your need is there for you to kneel down and pray to God. But God in his infinite mercy, the Lord and not the principle of everything, that same God Almighty, we said to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are you here? You profiling yourself to those who you should submit yourself, who do submit themselves to you. And you are walking in their order. You are telling them, look at Pastor Amos. He don't build house. Look at me. I never build. Look at this person. He don't bump again. Look at me. I never bump. It's not the factor. The factor is he that keepeth me never sleep nor slumber. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Look at the sister we started together. That sister have married. I have not married. That person is enjoying marriage. My marriage is not working. Hello! There is something that you must contend with. Your marriage might be given to you, but there are powers saying your marriage will not be sweet. But I pray for you today. By the order of God, your mother will receive a new order. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because of your single prayer that is being refused to your enemy, it has built up much affliction for you. There is a way out today. I prophesy. That way out you need to come out of that affliction that you suddenly find yourself at. By the order of God, with your three loud amen. Oh, yeah, let that way I'll show up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. I want you to shout out amen to this. Those who search for your secret place in order to hurt you, those that you freely submit your secret things to, those that gain entrance into your life in order to hurt you, those you granted audience in order to penetrate into your life to harm you, those people connected to you that are the source of your affliction, those in league with your opponent in the school of your sources, gang up of seers that look into your brighter destiny in order to frustrate your going in life, anyone opposing your rising and your shining, those you freely help and turn your life to her, the Lord will deliver you from their hands in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray authoritatively with your three loud amen. I say the Lord will deliver you from the hand of the enemy to your loss.
Amen. Jesus' name.
The Lord wants to send you help. Sit down. Today is another section of help. There are five categories of helpers that must meet with you after this section. And every one of them have blessings to offer you. They have it in their hands. They have it in their mouth. Number one, those who will help you to fulfill your destiny. Take note of this. There are five things that Jonathan did for David. He was the one who helped David to fulfill his destiny. So people that will help you, that you will miss after now, that will help you to fulfill your destiny, you will not miss them in the name of Jesus. Jonathan trained David from a childhood mindset to adulthood mindset. David was like 16 years when he met Jonathan. Or thereabout. And Jonathan was 40 years. Old boy. Do you understand that? And he turned into his friend. He said, this is my best friend. He trained him. What he could not gain from his brothers, stranger trained him. As a matter of fact, that stranger that the property of the father belongs to, the inheritance of the fathers belong to, he was the one that trained him. I pray today in the name of Jesus, those who will train your mind from being timid, that will train your mind to be somebody that will become great in life. I pray in the name of Jesus, arising from this meeting, God will call them to you in the name of Jesus. Those that will freely convert their rights to you. Jonathan said, I know this kingdom is given to you. Jonathan was the prince. But look for a stranger and said, the kingdom is given to you. So there are some people that will freely convert their right to you. I pray today as you are living this mountain, the Lord will connect them to you in the name of Jesus. Those who will conspire against anyone for your sake, just to make you to fulfill your dreams. Hear this. Jonathan said to David, go and hide in that place. If my father and mine and I, we are coming, I will show you signal. Even the father said to him, Jonathan, why are you conspiring with my enemy? When the man knew, Saul knew that his son is not in support of him to rule anymore. Saul called David, I know that God has given you the kingdom. Please remember me and my family. Even when he was still alive. I pray in the name of Jesus, those who will conspire against anyone for your sake, just to make the freedom to be fulfilled. This is number four. The Lord will connect them to you in the name of Jesus. Number five. Those who will not claim right, no matter how relevant it seems to them, in order to raise you to the position of power. Jonathan refused to claim right. Ordinarily, his apostle tell David, I will kill before my father king. You know what he's speaking in that place? Anointing. If you are the carrier of the anointing, people might not notice you, but one person that notices you might make you to be greater. It will be your voice in the mix of the multitude. What you need is not more people. What you need, you don't need so many people. You need one man who knows the man that knows that man. Do you hear me very well? You need one man. Who know the man that know that man? This is the connection you need. I hear this. Jonathan was a man. They know the man and understand the language for the season. He put confidence in his rival, supposed to be his rival, and said, the kingdom is given to you. How will David forget Mephibosheth? Help begat help. The help that Jonathan helped David was so mega than the help that David helped Mephibosheth. I pray today to everyone that shall not amen. The Lord will connect you to your helpers. In the name of Jesus. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. I said, God will connect you to helpers. In the name of Jesus. I want you to rule. Say, my helpers. Shout it very loud and clear. Hear the word of God. In the name of Jesus. As I'm clapping my hands. Oh yeah, look at me now. Look at me. Oh yeah. Stand up so you can pray very well.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You are that person you have promise and fear regularly that has been happening in your life. Please come forward. Some people will call you, they will tell you, we want to assist you. But we always forgetting when we want to do that. They will have done that before you are remembered. You have discovered you're supposed to be out of this country to your desired place. Or doing the business that you're supposed to be doing. You know you have been told severally. But there is a fault that is saying nothing good must happen to you. When it is the turn for your book of remembrance for helpers to locate you, nobody dare to speak for you. Mordecai was sleeping. And Haman, his enemy, was there. And people were speaking for Mordecai. Are you ready to shout? In the place of your remembrance, in the place of your remembrance, people must remember you. I pray for you today. But please, I want your amen to be louder. Nobody will shout amen for you. There are helpers that you have missed over the years. And the one I've missed over the years, through mistakes, through abomination, or so many things, I command in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah, let those helpers look at you in the name of Jesus. That is a helper, or there are helpers that carry your money in their mouth. They carry your prosperity in their hands. What you need to become, what you need to become, is inside their account. They are not using it. But the only thing is, instead of them to help you, they begin to pity you. Your helpers are not to pity you. They are helper. They are not your solicitor. When your helper turns to your solicitor, that is when they begin to pity you. I pray today with your servant running amen. If you have missed the link to your helpers, let there be divine connection. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want you to raise a divine connection between me and my helpers. Was that the loudest you can shout? Say, my love is available. In the name of Jesus. As I'm clapping my hands. Oh yeah, appear by fire. Appear by fire. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh, yeah. You better shout it now. Masaka pali basori basoto bayada.
Appear.
Masahiba lose a bloody ass of hell about Sotoba. Aha, 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 in the name of Jesus. Fire, 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 fire,
fire, fire, fire, fire,
fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire,
fire,
fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire, fire,
fire,
fire, in Jesus' name we pray. The Lord said to me, somebody is here. Power fighting your helper residing in you. Ogun to nba iwa ti olore reja on gbe nu e. I pray today. That power that is inside you that is fighting your helpers. I command in the name of Jesus. Oh yeah, let the power be disgraced and come out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's a yoke upon your head. Today is a fourth day of fasting. You are going to pray. Say every yoke.
Every yoke.
Shout it very loud and clear.
Every yoke.
Hear the word of God.
Hear the word of God.
Say every yoke.
Every yoke.
Well, that the loudest you can shout.
Well,
that the loudest you can shout.
Every yoke.
Hear the word of God.
Hear the word of God.
Say every yoke. You must break. Say you must break. Shout it very loud. Say every yoke. I want to hear that woman shouting out. That man is not shouting out. Say hear the word of God.
Every yoke.
Every yoke.
You must pray.
You must pray. We are going to turn it to some. Say every yoke. Say every yoke, hear the word of God. Every yoke, you must break. Is that okay? All ready to sing it now? Say every yoke, hear the word of God. Every yoke, you must break. Oh yeah.
Aha. Hear the word of God. Every yoke, you must break.
Oh yeah.
Every yoke, hear the word of God. Every yoke, you must
break. Lord, call Jesus. Aha.
Hear the word of God. Every yoke, you must
break. Oh yeah. Aha.
Bazakarabo
soto party as a hardy. Oh yeah, oh yeah, aha, aha. You are not shouting, you are not shouting. Let that yoke break in the name of Jesus. Aha.
You must break.
I like the way you are shouting now.
Yeah, the word of God. Every yoke, you.
5/10, 5/10. I want you to get 10/10. Let your voice be louder. Aha. Oh yeah.
Every yoke.
You must break. You must play, you must play, you aha.
You must play,
that thing in your body tormenting your going in life. Bazaka balia basari asaka tariasa. Aha, aha, aha. Loru God, Jesus, aha. In the name of Jesus, aha. In Jesus' name we pray. Isaiah chapter 10 verse 27 says, and it shall come to pass in that day that his body shall be broken away from thy shoulder. I command by the order of God, every burden of affliction, I want your amen to be louder. I pray in the name of Jesus. Oh yeah, pray. Every burden of lateness in your life, I come up by the order of God. Pray! Every burden that is not making your business to speak anymore. Burden that make you to sleep in the midst of plenty. And they tell you, from today, you are no longer relevant. I told you about a woman. She has been hoping to get a job in America. And the power from my foundation follow her there. Hear this. When she got to the office, she had been lobbying together for 10 years. She got there. As they were asking her question, the interviewer was asking that question. And this woman slept for 1 hour, 30 minutes. The interviewer didn't ask her not to sleep. She allowed this woman to sleep. She slept for 1 hour, 30 minutes, and she woke up. And the interviewer said, the position we want to put you is very sensitive. We don't need anybody to be sleeping in that position. There is one thing for you to gain entrance and access to a place. There's another thing for money, divine managerial power to control that place and to retain that place. So I pray in the name of Jesus. Power fighting you when you are almost getting to your place of promise or when you have gotten to the place of promise. Let the power flow the world.
Amen.
Now we want to command and contend against the power living inside of you to cement you. Say every power.
Every power.
You are not shouting now.
Every power.
The Bible said the stranger will hear my voice and they will run out of their hidden places. They will hear, they will fade away. Say every power.
Every power.
Living on my inside.
Living on my inside.
I'm still tormenting my growth in life. Say, what are you waiting for? Hear the word of God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah, destroy by fire. Destroy.
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 Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy.
Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy. Destroy.
Destroy.
Power coming between you and your helpers. Aha. Let the power destroy in the name of Jesus. Jesus, now we pray. You're a woman here. You started this year with happiness. But now, your happiness is going down every time. You are like somebody that wants to lose out of faith. Lord is saying, as you announced to you, because you are here today, it will connect you to your right source.
Amen.
Can I hear me be louder?
Amen.
The problem of 11 months over your life will suddenly disappear in one day.
Amen.
But the Lord is still saying, as you pray this prayer, who is that person? That thing fighting you and your helper, contending against your helper that reside on your inside. I pray in the name of Jesus, let God fire it out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Isaac, come on! Isaac, come on!
Amen.
Isaac, come on!
Amen.
Say, jump out, oh, jump out. Jump out, oh, jump out. Evil spirit in my body, jump out. Evil arrow in my body, jump out. Oh, yeah, oh, jump out, oh, jump out. Aha, jump out, oh, jump out.
Oh
yeah, evil power!
Jump
out! Loruko Jesu! Evil arrow! Evil personality! Sing it to the mountain! Loruko Jesu! In the name of Jesus! Aha!
Two
more times! You are not shouting! You are not clapping! You are not shouting! You are not clapping! The power fighting you will only answer up to warfare.
In my body,
jump out. In my body,
in my body,
jump out.
Aha! Jump out. In my body,
in my body,
in my body.
Jump out, jump out, jump out, jump out, jump out, jump out.
In my body,
in my body,
jump out,
jump out,
jump out.
Jump out
in my body.
Let that tragedy fight to you. Jump out in the name of Jesus.
In my body.
Let the power wing and that contending against your life. Jump out.
In my body. In my body.
I lay my hands upon that person.
In my body.
That spirit that will be contending against your life and not help you. Come out of that body. Aha.
In my body.
Aha. Aha. You are stranger that body. Bazakara Bosata. Bloody Bayata.
In my body. 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 Jump out.
In Jesus' name we pray. You went to a particular prayer house and they asked you to bring some substances that is not of God. So in that time, nothing is working. They ask you to bring a lot of things that you know, this is not church. You know. You know. But you took it there because you want everything to be settled. The Lord is saying that day, evil spirit enter into your body right from that fellowship. But you want to chase it out of your body. I will not call you out. You know I'm talking to you. I pray in the name of Jesus by the power of God. I want to chase it out. We are going to declare. Say, every evil object in my body.
Every evil object in my body.
Because of my previous errors and mistakes.
Because of my previous errors and mistakes.
Can you shout it very loud?
Every evil object in my body. Because of my past errors and
mistakes. Say, what are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?
Hear the word of God.
Hear the word of God.
As I'm clapping my hands. In the name of Jesus. Fire, jump out by fire. Jump out by fire.
Jump out by fire. Jump out. Jump out.
It's your day, it's your day, it's your day, it's your day. It's your day, it's your day, it's your day. A fire beside your
tongue. Don't bow, don't bow, don't bow, don't bow,
Yosa, na Yaza. Jesus' name we pray. Psalm 34 verse 19 says, many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. If you can shout this loud, amen. Every affliction in your body, I command by the order of God in the name of Jesus, receive deliverance.
Amen.
I pray for you as the oracle of God. I command in the name of Jesus, receive deliverance.
Amen.
From your head to your toes, receive deliverance.
Amen.
You that you are watching from your office or from your shop, I pray in the name of Jesus, you that you are watching from that sitting room, there is a snake in that sitting room that must come out. I command in the name of Jesus, that moving object to your house, oh, yeah, come on!
Amen.
Come on!
Amen.
Come on!
Amen.
I say, come on!
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, come on! Isaiah 49, verse 24 says, shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered? Are you here? You have been tied down by law. That whosoever that crossed this line in your family will not be amount to anything. You have been tied down by law. That anyone that look the way you look, or when you eat that food, or you marry to people from that place, and the law is working against you. I pray you are the lawful captives. Here verse 25 says, but thus hear the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away.
Amen.
Who are the captives of the mighty? People that have no power to deliver themselves. And the prayer of the terrible shall be delivered.
Amen.
For I will contend with him that contended with thee.
Amen.
And I will save thy children.
Amen.
I pray today in the name of Jesus. I want your servant running, amen. Let the power of God deliver you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Lifestyle that you are believing. You're supposed to be the breadwinner, but you are the bread eater. You are managing every process to your life and process of your life. You are living a life that believes to your standard every time you pray, but it's a prayer, it's not answering. I pray in the name of Jesus, by the power of God, let God raise you to your power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Isaiah 59 verse 19 says, so shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall lift up standard against them, against him. The standard of God. Say, standard of God.
Standard of God.
Can you shout it?
Standard of God.
Say, my life is available.
Life is available.
As I'm clapping my hands.
Oh yeah,
follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me. Aha. In the name of Jesus.
Follow me. 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 Follow me.
In Jesus' name we pray. Are you here? You have never manifested good things in your life before. You have long awaiting delay and nothing would happen. You've always been embarrassed at the verge of getting there. You are here. If your husband is not in your life, you cannot do anything. And you are here. You are still stealing from your wife. Your life is a life that is not stable. You are the victim of everything. You're always having constant battle attacks. You're always suffering from midnight battles and midnight wars. They afflict you with dreams. Instead of you to have the dream of progress, you have the dream of delay. You're always having negative dreams that prepare evil news in your life. You're always having dreams, you carrying caskets, selling things in the market square. You're always having dreams that you have been locked out of a particular gate and you have been begging to enter. I prophesy, I declare in the name of Jesus, if you are the victim to this thing that I've mentioned, I want everyone in the name of Jesus, you shall deliver 7 times. Oh, yes, shall deliver us in the name of Jesus. 1, 2, go!
Deliverance! 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 Deliverance!
Shalom! I pray in the name of Jesus. Any case in your life that needs deliverance, receive deliverance.
Amen!
Every covenant of look at it, but you will not get it.
In the name of Jesus.
Every covenant of get there, but you will not get it right. There are some things some people say, you pray. They say, I'm not going to marry. You marry. But when you get into the marriage, there is a problem. Woo. Sin. Who is being punished for this sin? As I know, the ancient sin. Prepare ancient siege. And that is what a lot of people are passing through the journey of life. But if God have called me today for this assignment, I prophesy in the name of Jesus, if that is your person, where you come out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every dream of denial.
In the name of Jesus.
When good thing is almost coming to you, you will dream. You will now discover that you bed wet in your dream and you come in the physical. Your body is being polluted. I pray in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah, let the dream of denial disappear.
Hey.
Once upon a time, one of our ministers many years ago, he dreamt. And said in his dream, he was eating okra. Somebody came to the bedside and fed him with okra. He wasn't our ministers at that time before he located here. Is here that God delivered him. And he said, when I woke up, sir, I saw okra in my mouth. Not I felt the odor. I was bringing out okra soup that I didn't eat. Are you hearing me? What that same person said, sir, anytime I sleep beside my wife on our matrimonial bed, I will always see myself under my wife's feet in the dream. Not in the physical. When I wake up to see myself under my wife's feet. I will lie down like this. My wife will put a leg on this. But I pray for you today.
Receive it.
Any area of your life that needs deliverance, if you are connected to this, I command by the order of God in the name of Jesus. Oh, you receive deliverance.
Amen.
If you leave this place today, by the grace of God, next week we'll go with another line of the helper that we need. I will talk about 4 lines of helpers. Then we go in removing that filthy garment. If you leave this place today, think that seems not working before, for you will start working.
Amen.
Then I want your amen to be shouting like a bazooka now. I pray in the name of Jesus, good thing that seems not working will start working.
Hey.
I pray in the name of Jesus, everything that tie your hands of business, that tie your hands of success, that tie your hands of breakthrough, that tie your hand of progress, everything that wants you to chase away your helpers from you, all that make you to chase away your helper from you, that make you to use your mouth to flog your helpers and run away, I prophesy in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah, let God deliver you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hey. I pray by the order of God. Every haven't reconfigured dream against your personality. Every reconfigured objects in your body, as we are growing, they are manifesting growth on it. That thing that is not making you to feel as if you are a complete human being is like a plague. I said something. When sickness goes to a higher degree, it will turn to infirmity. When the infirmity gets to a higher degree, it will turn to plague. Both sickness, infirmity, and plague in your body, by the power of God, I pray in the name of Jesus, oh yeah, disappear. Hey. Disappear. Hey. Lift up your hands, everyone. Say everything in my body. That I need to submit to the power of God. Say, what are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?
I want you to shout this as you return back to sea. Say, submit to the power of God.
Submit to the power of God.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Jesus' name we pray.
Hey.